if 60 or 70% of the leaders were women, say, make that imbalance flipped, but it would still be a very big imbalance.
Thank you very much for that. I want us to move. Are there any, or let me move to the next. Any urgent questions, Tricia?
Not so many questions as maybe comments, but maybe they lead to questions. So the first one was on the almost misconception that there's a differentiation between technology and then maths and physics, or maths and science. The two are very much reliant on each other. And it's interesting that there's a divide between people, or an assumption that there's a divide between people moving away from maths and physics at a school level but rushing towards technology, not realizing at their core they probably are really, really linked. Right, that's the first one. The second one is, I'm really intimidated by talking to such a young professor, and I forgot my second question. So let me pause there and come back.
When he's not thinking so much.
That's maybe a fair point. But so let me pause there, let him answer, and then I'll probably remember the next one.
Do you want to respond to the first question?
I feel like that is very important because technological advancement is dependent on math and science. And people were eager to get better technology back in the days when we couldn't just get food for free, when we couldn't just get free food, free water, and we had to actually work to, we had to use actual non-digital maps, and we had to plan out our routes instead of just entering two locations on Google Maps. So the thing is, back in those days, we were more reliant on maths and science, and we were able to see that connection, so we were more eager to do these kinds of things, to volunteer math and science, to do math and science things. But now, people just don't have that kind of, people don't have this kind of dependency on math and science anymore. Instead, they are dependent on technology, but then they think that there is no relation between math and science and technology, and then since we are stigmatizing math and science and making it seem like only the geniuses can do it, then they are rushing away from math and science and rushing towards technology. And now we are not only stigmatizing technology, but we are also making it so we can slow down technological advancement because we are slowing down mathematical and scientific advancement. So I feel like that's a really nice discussion, a really nice line of thought.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Prof. Bari.